Hello everybody, this is a standalone video. You don't need to watch it all. Read the description for shortcuts to different sections. Have fun! I already have a video on how to make bumpy ground, so click on the link that's appeared on the screen and you should go to it. It's a very nice video, I recommend checking it out. To change the size of the grid, press this button to make it smaller, and this button to make it larger. Next up, I'll show you the clipping tool. First of all, I'll just make a block. Now, the clipping tool is good for cutting things in half. So I'll just select the clipping tool here. You make sure what you want to cut in half is selected, then you hold down the mouse button and drag a line where you want the cut to be. The area that's in white will be left once you've pressed enter. With this, you can cut things in half, cut them into all sorts of angles and shapes and sizes. It's quite a nice tool to use, and I use it quite a lot. If you want both sides to be left after pressing enter, so that it's two separate blocks, you can keep on pressing on the clipping tool until the bit that's left is the bit that you want left. Press enter, and now you'll find that both parts are separate. Time to make some stairs. To do this, make a block where you want the stairs to be, and cut it in half with the clipping tool. There. Next, we need to make the steps. Now, I'll just place a person in here so you can see the scale. Stairs need to be at most 16 units high, but 8 is probably better. I'll just use 16 for now. So line it all up with the staircase, make the first step, then make the rest of them. Now, we need to select them all at once to save time. Hold down Control. Once they're all selected, click on the clipping tool again and cut off the bottom half, since it's inside the slopey bit and you don't need it. There we go. Whilst it's still selected, hold down Control and press T. This will make it a funk detail. Now, what that means at this stage is that it will be grouped together, but it also has other advantages. Your map will compile faster, your map will be smaller in size if you texture it properly, and it's just generally better. I don't tend to use it as much, but it does have a bit more flexibility to it. What it allows you to do, once you've selected it, is to drag out one of the sides, so you can make different shapes, like this. Now, once you've dragged it out, I tend to click on the selection tool, and it becomes the new shape. This is a very powerful tool to use, but there is a possibility that you'll mess everything up. For example, you can make extra bits that you can drag out by selecting the yellow bits, hold down Control to select more than one, and press Control F. I'll just do it again. This side is now made of three different bits. If I drag out one of these bits, it should all go wrong. Yeah, look at that. This bit shouldn't be there. This will mess everything up when you load up the game, so you've got to be very careful with the vertex tool when you use it not to make shapes that go wrong. The Valve website recommends only making one extra bit per side, and this won't happen. I recommend that as well. Or just don't do it at all and just use blocks and make multiple blocks next to each other. And that way you can avoid the entire problem altogether. You can mess around with that in your own time. It's a very powerful tool, but I don't tend to use it that much unless I'm editing complex shapes. There are a lot of pre-made shapes that you can use in Hammer. If you select the block tool, you can then go down to the right-hand side of the screen and you should have this menu somewhere. From here, you can choose different shapes that you might want to use. For example, if you want to make a sphere, click on the sphere, drag it out, and when you press enter, it'll become a sphere. You can edit the detail of it by changing this number before you make it. So if I go up to the top, which is 16, and drag it out again, it crashes. No, it doesn't. That's good. It's far more detailed. Of course, it'll slow down computers more, but since Source is so old, it shouldn't matter too much. Just don't make a whole world full of balls. As well as the sphere, you can use this to make cylinders, arches. The block tool is the default one. Choose this once you want to go back to normal. The bottom three I don't use that much. You can mess around with them. The arch tool is the difficult one. Select that and drag out a block. Press enter and up comes this menu. Now the best thing to do here is trial and error, mess around with different settings, see what it looks like. The top three are the only three you need to make an arch. The bottom one will allow you to make staircases where each step goes up further, but I won't talk about that now. So for example, if I want an arch, 16, I'll change this to 16 as well so it's more detailed, and that remains 180. Click OK, and there you have an arch. Now I'll rotate that round the right way, click on the selection tool, and you'll see these appear. Drag it down to the half size so it's a proper arch instead of a stretched one. Now to rotate it round the right way, and this applies to anything, click on it until these small circles appear. You can now drag these around, and look, you can rotate it. Sometimes it takes a bit of trial and error. Hopefully I'll get it right first time. Yeah, and there's an arch. If you want to have sides to these arches, I'll just choose the block tool again, make the grid smaller, and I'll drag these down. Oh, beautiful. And there you have it, an arch.